I was actually in Ocean City on a boat that I owned, and we had a steering malfunction. We were driving around in the Assawoman Bay.
Oh yeah, I know that
well. Favorite bay,
very popular.
Yeah,
and we had a steering malfunction, and I was thrown from the boat, and the boat, it had twin outboards that were not counter rotating. The motors cocked sideways and threw the boat into a spin. I got thrown out, and the boat circled around and hit me.
Oh, I never want to go on a boat again.
If I had been wearing the, and this is true, it's not a joke, but if I had been wearing the safety lanyards, the boat would have shut off. So
sort of
it's
like
kind of.
a much smaller version, like when people like rent jet skis and
it's the
stuff.
Exact same thing.
And if you get thrown from it, it
it's
pulls
that little
the key
squiggly
off.
Thing that you attach
exactly.
to it. Like they have those on treadmills too, in case you're uncoordinated.
I've
fall
needed
off the
them before, yeah.
I've had some bad treadmill accidents.
So what happens in that moment? And Paul Mittemeyer joins us here, who's lost a limb because of boats in the past. In that moment when you lose your arm as you float into those engines, do you know what's happened to you? I've heard that the pain is almost so much your brain won't even let you process it. What are you feeling?
Yeah, I didn't really feel a whole lot of pain, and I kind of, you know, I saw the boat coming at me. I put my arm up to try to stop it, and obviously, you know,
yeah,
I lost.
That ain't
it
happening.
Just kind of, yeah. It didn't get cut off. It just got shredded up pretty bad. And, you know, you kinda,
I almost prefer it just be
second,
cut off cleanly instead of having to look at like the ribbons of what was my arm.
And that's pretty much what it was.
When did you come to the realization? You're like, you know what? I lost my arm, but I'm still gonna get out there. And did people say, what are you talking about? You're crazy.
I got my captain's license after I lost my arm. I had a center console boat. I was roofing, and I roofed without an arm for forever.
I can't roof with two arms.
You're like my hero.
Probably not in real life.
just based on what I've heard. I don't want to know anything more.
But no, yeah, now you'd be surprised.
Well, because
you
I don't know much about driving a boat, but I know you got like the throttle here and the steering wheel here, and you only got one arm.
It's a two arm operation.
Yeah.
The throttles, when you push them up, they'll stay up.
Yeah.
And I've got a twin engine boat, and you can pretty much drive that just like a, you know, skid steer. Or
did anybody try to tell you, what do you mean you're going for your captain's license? Everybody knew you, like, all right, he's going to do it.
They pretty much don't waste their breath on telling me anything.
And Paul, the guy to your right, you know, he loses his leg. He gets a Swiss Army knife of different contraptions and prosthetics, and I notice no prosthetic with you.
I do have a prosthetic, but it's more of a social crutch.
Oh, you just wear it to make us normies feel comfortable
we
can eat?
It's
not really functional.
Conversation piece.
Gotcha.
It's not. You can do a little bit with it. Yeah. And it actually helps with my back some, just because I'm kind of off center.
Got it.
Oh, I didn't even think about that. Yeah, one side of your torso is heavier than the other, so it's probably pulling your spine. Fish aren't the only thing you've ever found in the water.
This is going back to the dead body, isn't it?
Damn right it is. Yeah.
That's a weird day.
That was,
a strange day.
It was actually turned out to be a good day. It started out good. It was a slick, calm day. The guy, Will Billy, who's on the show with me, was actually mating on my boat then, and he was kind of a stand-in mate that day. We had caught a bunch of tunas, and it looked like we were actually going to get back to the dock in a reasonable time. A lot of times we'll fish late if the fishing isn't good. And I told him, I said, I'll have you back on the dock by 4 o'clock today.
Yeah.
And we're driving around, it's slick calm, and we see something floating in the water.
Oh, no.
And usually if you see something floating, you'll go over there, and it's, you know, it could be
trash.
A log. Yeah, and there's usually mahi-mahi, the fish swimming around it.
Okay.
So we figured, okay, we'll go over there, catch some mahis. It'll be, you know, cherry on top of the day.
Nice lunch.
And we get exactly.
And instead, we
see a body, and I'm pulling up, and I'm like, man, that looks like a body, and Will Billy was like, "F yeah, that's a dead body."
Like he'd seen them before. He identified, "Oh, I know a body, and that's a body."
And I mean, Matt, I guess immediately you just call authorities, right? And you're like,
We called the Coast Guard, and they asked if we could just
like
circle around it,
or,
and then they couldn't get to us, and then they asked if we could retrieve the body.
Do you get a check for that?
Wait,
no,
so you
it
did?
It would have been nice. I told the Coast Guard, I'm like, I got a party on board here, and I don't know that I want to pull a body on the boat.
You had a boat full of people. You're on a charter.
Yeah.
Ooh.
And
you're
going to
hand all those people refunds if you bring some floater on board.
We actually had an unusual charter that day. We had a bunch of biker roofers on the boat.
So
and
they were probably
about 50 years old.
So
and
they're
like,
diving
hell
in after.
Yeah, let's bring this body back.
Yeah, that's awesome. So, yeah, bring it on. Root through its pockets.
You did you?
We couldn't find the body again, but we drove around and there was three other boats and the body, I don't know if it's submerged, but we couldn't find the body again because I was like, all right, guys, you know, if you want to bring it home, we'll bring it home. Like, when we roll him over, his face is probably going to be gone.
Oh, wait, so did they ever find it?
On it?
They never found it, but we did retrieve a piece of fabric that was floating with the body that was still there, and it looked like it was a burial at sea.